Hi friends, all of you welcome once again. Today lectures we are discussing about isolation and separation of nucleic acids from E. coli. So here the fourth step is purification and concentration of the DNA. We know very well purification of the DNA was achieved, the complete removal of RNA, complete removal of proteins. RNA does not normally precipitated like DNA. Even if we are adding ethanol and salt solution, the RNA does not normally precipitate like DNA. How means the RNA already degraded. Already degraded by the ribonuclease enzyme. Yes. Even some amount of RNA may be present in the DNA solution or aqueous phase. Once again, you repeat the chloroformal isomerization procedure. You get purified, highly purified form of DNA. Followed by ethanol precipitation, you can get highly purified form of DNA. So for this step, we can get only 50% of the cellular DNA. So please keep your mind. This is very important. So if we achieve this 50%, we can follow this all step treatment of ribonuclease, treatment of proteinase, proteinase K, phenyl chloroform isoleucine treatment, or ethanol precipitation. So then only we got 50% each one. In other words, say 1 to 2 milligram of DNA we get from the per gram of wet bacterial cell. So per gram of bacterial cell, only we get 1 to 2 milligram. Just imagine, this is up to 50%. This is indicate 50%. So how we get the 50%? We can maintain the four steps. We got a healthy growth cells and also effective method for disturbing cells and the effective method for removal of cell derpings and the effective method for purification. So followed by this step, we got 50% of cellular DNA can be isolated. So after we purify the DNA, the DNA get pelleted by centrifugation and stored for some time for future studies. How we get the pellet? After centrifugation, the DNA redissolved with the buffer containing EDTA, the buffer without DNA enzyme. The buffer is called TRIS-EDTA buffer, TRIS-TE buffer, TRIS-EDTA buffer, and the pH, especially pH, is 8. So this buffer is a suitable buffer for storing the purified DNA and resuspended and stored at 40 centigrade at least for 1 month. So please ensure this buffer containing no DNAs. Then only the stored solution was exactly stored at to 1 month. So here, this is a simple protocol mentioned here. First, homogenize the cell and tissue, followed by cellular lysis and chelating agent. We are using only EDTA and the proteinase treatment with the help of proteinase K, the phenyl chloroform extraction using saturated chlorophenol and chloroform solution and aldehyde precipitation, especially using 70% of ethanol, finally redissolved the DNA by T buffer. So this is the basic steps we are going to do. So here cell is try to broken down, or individual cells are maybe got after homogenation. This is cell lysis used chemical method, disturbing cell wall, detergent, especially STS lysozyme. This is a chelating process with the EDTA, proteinase treatment, removal of proteins, phenyl chloroform extraction, removal of proteins from the DNA, and alkyl precipitation precipitate the DNA from the aqueous solution and resuspected using T buffer. So after purify, remove the DNA from the cellular tissue, we can measurement the DNA concentration. This is more important. Why this is more important? Because we got the pellet, you know, we are visibly know this is a pellet, but we got pure DNA or unpure DNA, yes, we can measure the DNA concentration. How we measure the DNA concentration means, the famous method is called UV spectrophotometer method. This the exact determination of concentration of DNA using spectrophotometer and take absorbance at 260 nanometer. When they take the absorbance at 260 nanometer, the OD indicates 1, the OD indicates 1, the OD indicates corresponds the mixture containing 50 milligram DNA per ml. This is the indicate, the 260 absorbance indicate pure form of DNA present in the given sample. So one more method is that you can determine the structure of DNA or molecular weight of the DNA determined by gel electrophoresis. Okay. It's a famous term. But this entire procedure have some demerits. So you can rectify this demerits. You can choose the another method of isolation of human DNA. It's called a density gradient ultracentrifugation. It's the famous method using cesium chloride. We can go to, we discuss the another video in future. This method, we got high degree of purified DNA. Yes. Suppose we can take the specific gene from the genome DNA, you can choose this method, it's more better. Yes. Suppose you can choose the virus as a source of DNA or another small particles as a source of DNA, you can choose the density gradient simplification as the suitable method. For avoid this demerits in the alkalinization method. So please, my dears, thank you for watching this video. I would like to convey a message. If you are satisfied the information from this video, then only you share, like, and subscribe. Once again, thank you.